Hey, how are you? The week's running down here in Lancaster. The boys and I figured we should try and take a few more trips out of the area, try to see as much of Great Britain as possible. So if you remember, we went on the trip to Liverpool, our boy Ben Roy wasn't with us. He was in Edinburgh in Scotland. Nothing but good things to say about it. So we're about ready to head out today. Just waiting for the other lads to get out of class, but in that time, figured I should get in the spirit of Scotland and indulge in some of my Laphroaig Select. This is Islay single malt Scotch whiskey. I had it before at home, but I figured I had to get some here in the UK. So, looking forward to a good trip to Edinburgh. We're gonna catch a train. Here's Edinburgh. Let's get this show on the road. So unlike the last time we left, went to Liverpool, I am alive, awake, alert, and enthusiastic because it's not 5 in the morning. It's about 3 in the afternoon or so, and we're just waiting for Ben Roy to get stuff together. It's weird, it's sunny, but it's raining, and we do have a beautiful rainbow, which I will get a shot of right now. So hopefully this is a good omen for our trip, you know? Nice, beautiful freaking rainbow. And here we have the rats of Lancaster University, the Mallard clan, and here's Big Sizz, trying to assimilate with them. They appear to be rejecting him. These are the real troublemakers in this neighborhood. They come in here and they cause a bunch of no good ruckus.
No good ruckus.
No good.
After cranking down a few termies on our 3-hour train ride, we arrived.
The boys and I found a pub at the upper end of the Royal Mile near the castle and decided to go all in on a proper Scottish meal. So we've arrived here in Edinburgh. We cranked down about 4 cans of beer on the train ride, so we're feeling pretty tremendous right now. I'm here with the boys. Big Sizz and Spicy Sizz. They already went in and got some Guinnesses. And we're here at the Ensign Stewart. And we're gonna order some pub feed. What are you boys thinking?
Well, all I want and all I need is a good pub feed.
Exactly. All you crave is a good pub feed. Good. Well, you know, this is my first night in Scotland, so I'm gonna have to go all in. I'm gonna order the Haggis and get a double shot of Lagavulin, Ron Swanson's favorite. So we'll get back as soon as that comes out, and we'll let you know how that is.
So this is the first Lagavulin I've ever ordered. I've always wanted one, and here I am in Scotland. This is just the perfect place to do it. I'm gonna shut up and just tell you how it tastes. Unfucking believable. That is A1.
There it is.
Definitely has a bit more of a bite to it than the Laphroaig, but it's got that peaty single malt Islay Scotch taste, and I love it.
So here we go. We've got our Haggis. Looks a little different than what I was expecting, but let's dig on in.
You like what?
Yeah. One bite, everybody knows the rules.
There's a documentary on Netflix, I can't remember what it's called. I'll sign you the name when I get in. I can't remember what it's called. But it's about a guy that basically just like takes on the wine industry. It's amazing.
Unbelievable. This is good.
Really?
I don't know why people freak out over this. Hi, Big Sizz. What did you get?
I got some cheesy garlic bread.
Cheesy garlic bread looks basically like any old garlic bread because you are 10-ply. Now,
softer than
10-ply. Spicy says, what'd you get there?
Scottish venison casserole with bread and butter. And it is,
hello.
That's how it feels.
So, how are we feeling right now?
Feeling great.
Yeah?
Look at all these lights, man.
I'm a little concerned about the situation in the Middle East, but, you know, other than that. Like,
well, why? Good. Why exactly?
Well, I think, you know, we pulled out on the Kurds, and that was kind of a low blow, but I just think, like, the destabilization that's been going on ever since 1919 has been problematic. And, you know, I think...
No, you're right.
Without the dominance of a major Muslim power, I don't think the Middle East can ever be.
You're exactly right, but I love you. I don't mean to cut you off, but let's move over here and just take a look at, how freaking beautiful this city is. Like, goddamn Edinburgh. Like, why are you so beautiful? So, day two here in Edinburgh. What's the plan, boys?
We're gonna climb up Archer's Seat, and then we're gonna come back. We're gonna go to the Christmas Village, like a couple of hardos.
Yeah? What's at the Christmas Village?
Christmas shit, man, I don't know.
Bowling on past, we find this, this place called the Royal Mile Gallery. Ben, what have you discovered? And
enough said. We made our way down the Royal Mile towards Arthur's Seat, a huge mountain smack dab in the middle of the city. That is, according to legend, one of the possible locations of King Arthur's Camelot.
Camelot.
Camelot. Camelot.
It's only a model.
Number one, real mountaineering talk. This is what we said back on K2 when I was with the Gurkhas. You gotta say, I wanna get up on that bitch. And that's mountaineering talk for I'm gonna climb that. You know, so if you wanna be a real A1 authentic mountaineer, you say, I wanna get up.
We're gonna get up on that bitch. And that's what we're gonna do.
Hey, TV, this is my crib or cave, and I kind of like sleep over there. That's kind of it.
Summit of a hill, little hill. You can't really see much from up here, except for some birds.
You know, the whole city.
Some birds, some rocks. No, it's freaking beautiful up here. The video footage really just doesn't do it justice. Hey, stop. I want you to use your interpretive skills and interpret this rock.
Instead of doing that, what you're gonna do is you're gonna edit some bagpipe music, and I'm gonna sprint to the top of the hill.
Okay. Spicy Sizz was being a little bitch about interpretation earlier. We at the National Park Service, we're gonna take this into our own hands, and I'm going to interpret this rock for you. So we're gonna go back about 500 years ago,
from every day, a famous Highlander named Sean Connery would come to this rock and meet all the little children from the Highlands. Now these children would often bully poor Sean because he had a lowland accent and he was not welcome here in the Highlands. And every day, Sean would stumble down from this mountain defeated. But one day, Sean ran into another Highlander. And that Highlander looked at him and says, "Sean, don't let those children bully you. You can be whatever you want to be." That Highlander was Groundskeeper Willie. And because of Groundskeeper Willie, Sean Connery went on to play James Bond. And that's the story of this rock.
So, why do you pick this way, Spice? Looks pretty hazardous.
Well, here's the funny thing. I'm actually totally dumb.
Oi, Ben, what do you see? Pig says, where's he at? Really good. Plus. Oh shit! Can you get a shot at him?
I'm getting a shot.
Okay. Oh my God, that's a monster.
Look at his thighs.
Massive thighs.
Oh,
he's barreling down. Oh, shit! Oh, shit!
Down.
So, we picked quite possibly the worst way to come down.
Definitely.
As evidenced by the fact that no one else came down this way.
Yeah, because they're not A1 Mountaineers.
True. True.
There's gotta be a little rock climb somewhere.
Benjamin Roy Mountaineering Company, hire me out. I will take you literally the worst route.
The whole mountain was teeming with ravens, which are pretty much just majestic-ass crows that don't eat garbage. These cliffs, known as the Salisbury Crags, used to be open to rock climbing, but closed a few years ago due to climbing accidents. It's pretty easy to see why.
So, Ben, rumor has it that that Arthur's Seat is an extinct volcano. Do you know how long ago it went extinct?
Yeah, I'm not an expert, but I'd say maybe like 30 years ago, maybe.
So, we've made it off the mountain, but we've all fallen on our asses at least once.
Casualties were sustained.
But we made it. A Pyrrhic victory, I'd say. Although,
ski down that one.
I fell a grand total of 30 feet from this trail that we're on. Like, so close to the bottom.
You gotta find a positive in the situation. We're now all Soggy Bottom Boys.
We are.
Soggy Bottom Boys.
Yeah.
There's your silver lining.
So in Liverpool, we had a hard time finding a place that had Murphy's, but here we are at the Kilderken in Edinburgh, and guess what we found? Murphy's. And this is Big Ben's first time trying Murphy's. So just give us a live reaction here. Tell us what you think.
You ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready? All right.
It's a lot sweeter than Guinness.
Yep.
It's got something about it that Guinness doesn't have. It might be like less metallic. It's good. I like it.
Excellent. That's why it's the best. All right, boys, I just took a nap, did a little running around after lunch, and now it's very dark, very early, but what are we doing now?
We are going to Christmas Village. We're gonna go sit in Santa's lap. And
What do you want for Christmas? What are you gonna tell Santa that you want for Christmas?
Alcohol.
Okay. What about you?
Alcohol.
Good boys.
On the island to the Sunset Strip, somebody's gonna make a happy trip tonight while the moon is bright. He's gonna have a bag of crazy toys to give the cornies of the girls and boys all day. Santa comes on big.
Now that we're in the Christmas Village, we are on a mission. We need to find the Johnny Walker tent.
Have you seen Johnny Walker?
Have you seen him? Have you seen this man? And what'd you get?
Blue vine?
Blue vine. And can you explain to everyone what blue vine is?
Don't really know, but from what I can tell, what I can taste, it's like a mulled wine.
Mulled wine?
You know,
what's mulled wine?
It's hot wine.
Hot spices, wine.
Stuff like that.
Spices. It's pretty interesting. I had some myself. It's got a cinnamon cinnamon afterbirth. It's bit of an oaky afterbirth as well.
It's hot red wine.
Hot red wine. I got just hot chocolate with Bailey's Irish cream. Can hardly taste the alcohol. There's really not much in it, but it's really good.
Well, we needed to make our way
up. Yeah, we found that...
Just need something to get us up to the Johnny Walker.
The Johnny Walker bar is all the way up there where that sign is behind them.
It's not even the Johnny Walker tent. It's like a
Bunker. So we're going to need to make our way all the way up there. We're going to get some food next, and we'll let you know how that is.
All right, Benny. So here we are. What is this place? The Pizza Pitch? It's just this little stand in the main drag here at the Edinburgh Christmas Village. And I was having an inkling for pizza, so I just went ahead and I got this humble margarita pizza. That's what it's called. Humble margarita. Only 8 pounds. Not too bad. One bite, everybody knows the rules. I don't know. It's a pretty small pizza. I don't know what to expect. We are in Scotland, so, you know, one bite, everybody knows the rules. Let's go for it. Pizza Pitch, humble margarita, one bite, everybody knows the rules. All right. Again, I know I said I didn't know what to expect, but this was exactly what I expected. It's definitely crisp. They made it right in front of me. I saw that. I give them credit for that. But all in all, this is about a 6.4. 6.4 is all I'm going to give this. One bite, everybody knows the rules. I can't complain. It's pizza. We got to get a move on now. Let's go, Benny.
We found the Johnny Walker bar, so hopefully we'll be feeling much better very shortly. So we actually have kind of a tragedy here at the Johnny Walker bar. I was hoping you'd just get a nice single or a double of Johnny Walker, but they don't serve it straight. I asked the lady at the bar, do you just serve Johnny straight? And she said, no, we only do it in ginger ale or mixed in with hot apple cider. So I said, all right. I'm gonna take one for the team, strike to my manhood. I got Johnny Walker Red and ginger ale. It hits me hard because normally I would never do this, and it's definitely a strike against my masculinity. But I'm gonna get through this. Are we gonna get through this, boys?
We'll be fine.
Yeah. All right.
You were soft before. You're soft now.
All right, so we got out of Christmas Town. Johnny Walker Bar, very underwhelming. Now we're just moving our way down the strip here.
Lingerie!
Yeah, there's a whole lingerie store right here. Wow, all right. But anyway, we're gonna try and find, apparently, Spicy Sizz back here, who's digging into his churros, is saying there is an entire street nothing but pubs.
Can you imagine if chimps had the same freedom as humans?
The rest of the evening descended into chaos as we went from pub to pub, destroying our livers one pint at a time.
Every time it rains, and it's from heaven.
Shoo-be-doo-be.
Don't you know each cloud contains banners from heaven?
Shoo-be-doo-be.
You'll find your
idiot right there. You see that guy?
Yeah, what? What?
We're here at. Yeah, what the hell's the name of this pub? Oh,
Kenilworth.
Kenilworth.
What do you have, Big Sis?
Sunshine and Johnny Walker.
Macaroni. If you want the things you love, you must have a pizza, holy baby. And when you hear thunder, don't run under a tree. Every penny's from heaven.
He said he could be growing cereals. Well, man, nurtured his trees. Then pressed and blended his apples. Pioneering a new standard for British cider.
Do you know how hard it was?
I hate the French.
Jack Pierce would be proud as fuck right now.
Let's go!
So we found ourselves back in the Christmas Village, but we're gonna need to get out.
We're about to head out in the Christmas
Village. We still have enough energy to hit up another pub. And would you believe our luck? Come out of the Christmas Village, we find the malt shovel. We're gonna get our malts shoveled. Let's hope. Let's hope.
Almost 300 years old. We are screwed for the future.
And you'll find your fortune falling all over town. Get pennies from heaven. Pennies from heaven. Pennies from heaven for you and me.
And that is all.